Hello guys, Dr. Hasbullah here, and in this video, we're going to be looking at a little bit more derivation to get a bit deeper into this topic. Okay, so basically we already have the equations for T naught over T, P naught over P, and rho naught over rho. Okay, and in this video, we're going to try to find the area ratio, right? This is very important because if you want something to be supersonic, and if you want to design something, then you need to know what's the area, right? And after we do that, I'm going to show you that if we have the converging and diverging duct, okay, what happens to the pressure inside depending on whether the flow is supersonic or not. And I'm going to do that graphically so it's easier for you to understand, okay? And later we'll do some examples. Like I said before, we already have the equation for temperature at the throat, okay? And we know the pressure at the throat and we also know the density at the throat. Okay, now perhaps it will be in our interest to know if there is an area at the throat, the ratio of the area between the inlet and the throat where it should be met in order to produce the supersonic flow. Okay, and let's see how to get that. And for that, we need to go back to the continuity equation, which is m dot equal to rho times velocity times area. Alright? And we know now that we are dealing with compressible flow, so we're going to have to make some adjustment to this. We know that density, velocity, and area changes a lot, okay? So rho, okay, we know that P equal to rho RT, okay? So rho equal to P over RT, that's the ideal gas equation. So this is P over RT. Also, Mach number is M equal to velocity divided by speed of sound, okay, that gives you velocity equal to Mach number times speed of sound. So this is Mach number times speed of sound times area. Okay, and speed of sound is square root of k times r times t. Right, so I'm going to write it here. M dot will become p over rt. This is m square root of k rt times area. Alright, and we have RT here, and we have RT here, and let's see how we are going to group this together. So the way I'm going to do it is like this. So I'll have here P square root of T K over R times area times Mach number, okay? And I know my relationship between P over P naught, and I know my relationship between T over T naught. Okay, and my relationship is here. Okay, T naught over T, P naught over P, and rho naught over rho. Sorry about that. Now, what I want to use now is this bit and this bit, only between temperature and pressure. Okay, but you must notice that this is T naught over T. Okay, and this is P naught over P. And what we have here is T and P. So now the relationship of P over P naught will be P over P naught equal to 1 plus K minus, so this is 1 plus K minus 1 over 2 M square. Let's take a look at the power. So this is to the power of K over K minus 1. Right? K over K minus 1. But when we rearrange this, so this is going to be negative, isn't it? Okay, because now we need P over P naught, right? This is P naught over P. So just flip that around. So that will be minus K over K minus 1. Okay, and similar thing with T over T naught. I think this is 1 plus K minus 1 over 2 M square. Okay, let's take a look here. So this is the relationship, right? But T over T naught is now negative 1. Alright? So now I want to put everything inside this equation. Okay? So now P becomes P naught. Okay? 1 plus K minus 1 over 2 M square minus K over K minus 1. Alright? And you know what? The easier thing to do is to replace the denominator so that everything becomes negative. Okay, so this will be, okay, let me handle this. Okay, so this will be K over 1 minus K. Okay, see, I'm just gonna replace this 1 minus k and k minus 1. So just so that I can get rid of the negative sign, right? So this is divided with t naught times 1 plus k minus 1 over 2 m square minus 1 over 2. Okay, and this is still k over r times area times Mach number. Okay, and I think t naught here should be square root. So what I need to do now is that I need to minus this power. Okay, so what I have now will be p naught, let's do this, k over r t naught times area times Mach number times 1 plus k minus 1 over, sorry, this is k minus 1 over 2 m square, and my power now will be k over 1 minus k minus, so minus minus, that will be plus 1 over 2. And how do we do this? So this is 2k plus 1 minus k over 2, 1 minus k. So k, if it here, so what you have is k plus 1 over 2, 1 minus k. Alright, so this is your m dot. Basically, that's your mass flow rate. Okay, I'm gonna highlight this equation. Okay, so that is your mass flow rate. So can you find mass flow rate at the throat? Right? Of course you can. So at the throat is simply Mach number equal to 1. What you have now is that at Mach number equal to 1, m dot is still m dot. This is still p naught square root of k over rt. Area is now become area asterisk, right? Because this is area at the throat, right? M is 1. So this is simply 1 plus k minus 1 over 2. K plus 1 over 2, 1 minus k. So the first and second equation is still the same m dot, right? Sorry about that. Okay, so this is still the same m dot. It's just that this m dot is taken at the throat. Because it's the same, what if I equate these two equations, right? I can equate these two equations so that I can have the relationship of A over A star, which is our objective from the very beginning. So we already have temperature, pressure, density, and now we have relationship of the areas, right? So this becomes, is equal to 1 over M, okay, this is 2 plus K minus 1 m square over k plus 1, k plus 1 over 2, k minus 1. Okay, that's the end. Alright, so this is it. This is the relationship that you are looking for when you want to find out the relationship between the area at the inlet and the area of the throat. Another interesting observation is that for this equation, it shows that the mass flow rate is totally depending on the area of the throat. So if you change the area of the throat, the mass flow will change. Now that we know the relationship of the areas, I told you earlier that I want to show you graphically how the pressure changes as the flow goes through the nozzle, right? Converging, diverging nozzle. Let's say this is your nozzle. Okay, and the flow will be going from left to right. And this is the exit. And this is your reservoir. So reservoir, the notation for reservoir is always P naught, T naught, and rho naught. And obviously, this is the throat. And down here, I'm going to plot a graph. Okay. And this is x-axis, which is correspond to the exact location of the nozzle, right? And here I have pressure over P naught. Okay, and P naught, again, P naught is the pressure at the reservoir, right? And let's see if there is no flow at all. So pressure anywhere is here, okay? So if there's no flow, then along the nozzle, the pressure is the same, okay? So P over P naught is 1. What if I have some flow in it, right? Not very much, okay? I have some flow going through it, but the flow is subsonic, okay? So M is less than 1. So what happened is that, okay? So when M is less than 1, we know that the pressure will drop, okay? And why does the pressure drop? Because when you decrease the area, velocity will increase, okay? And when velocity increase, pressure will drop. And at the throat, okay, we know that the pressure will go back to 1. The pressure ratio will go back to 1 because when you increase the area, the velocity goes slowly again, right? And when the velocity slowly, and when velocity decrease, the pressure will increase again. That is when Mach number is less than 1, okay? And this is no flow at all, right? Meaning Mach number equal to 0, okay? So now, what happens if I have the pressure ratio just enough to make Mach number equal to 1 at the throat, okay? So Mach number equal to 1, okay? So let's do this, right? So in this line, okay, and achieve Mach number equal to 1, right? And this goes back up again, right? So what happens here? Okay, so this is Mach number equal to 1. Okay, so what happens here? So basically, Mach number gets to 1 at the throat, but the pressure is just not sufficient to bring the flow into supersonic flow. Okay, so what happens after the throat? Okay, then the velocity reduces again because area increases. So what happens is that the pressure returns back to normal, right? And guess what? What is the value here? Okay, and I think we have this value, which is here. Okay, so P at the throat divided by P O is 0.5283. So exactly, this is 0.5283. Okay, what if I increase the pressure difference? Okay, I really want the flow to be supersonic, and what happens if I increase the pressure difference, right? And if I increase the pressure difference so that the ratio is greater than or lower than 0.5283. Now, if I continue to increase the difference in pressure, meaning that I want to make the pressure even lesser than this, what happens is that the flow will follow this line, okay? Right, remember this is Mach number equal to 1. So it still follows this line, right? But here at the throat, the flow will continue to accelerate. Okay, meaning that when the flow accelerates, the pressure will continue to go down. This means the flow is supersonic. Okay, so when the pressure ratio between the throat and the reservoir can overcome this pressure ratio, okay, only then the flow goes supersonic, right? So that's why this relationship is very important, okay? Because without this, the flow will not go supersonic. Okay, guys, so I think this is where I end this video. I hope now that you get sense of understanding of why we derive those equations and how to use it, okay? How to determine whether the flow will go supersonic or not. Okay, don't worry, because after this, in the next video, we're going to be working on a few examples so you can see more clearly about when to use when. Right, right now, you have a lot of parameters. You have P naught, you have P, T naught and T, rho naught and T. You might now know how to derive the equation, but you may not be able to use it yet. But even so, we will keep building on what we know. So it's very important that you redo this derivation until you get it. So repeat this video again and again until you can do it without even looking at this video, right? And then you will be in a comfortable position to do the tutorials later. Okay, thank you very much. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.